The following video was sponsored by the Greek American Heritage Society of Philadelphia, preserving and promoting our community's history.
Today, we, as we always, as a priest, I always remember the clergy who served this beautiful parish, especially Father John Limberakis, who worked together with all of you from years past to move from our former house of worship here on Trooper Road to be the only parish in the Delaware Valley that is on a major thoroughfare. Every other parish, and I've been to all of them, you kind of have to follow along the roads to get to. But St. Sophia is out for everyone to see as they travel through Montgomery County. And many years ago, Metropolitan Evangelos, along with President Elizabeth and the Limberakis family, through the generosity of Nick Boris, who wanted to be anonymous, but we didn't last too long with that, dedicated this cultural center in the memory of Father John. This beautiful plaque is offered to honor Father John in the parish of St. Sophia, but the other parishes that he built, building four communities, four houses of worship. And the plaque emulates this building, the arches that are above here, with the name of Hagia Sophia and the original logo that was created for the church.
Handwritten.
Handwritten, yeah. Yeah. And this image of Father John, which was here when we dedicated the building, is now in place. So with that, let us offer a prayer as we bless this marker, this beautiful seal of God's grace through the priesthood of Father John. Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Again, we pray for the repose of the soul of the servant of God, John the protopresbyter, our brother and co-celebrant who has fallen asleep, and for the forgiveness of his every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
For you are a merciful God, and unto you do we give glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. May your memory be eternal, our brother who are worthy of blessedness and everlasting memory. May your memory be eternal, our brother who are worthy of blessedness and everlasting memory. May his memory be eternal. May God rest his soul, and may he set always the good example for us clergy who strive to build up the body of Christ and the buildings in which we gather in. And you're the Nivaptis, O Manus, O Kyrie, itis trianus e phaneroti proskinisis. Tu garienitoros iphoni cross e martirisi agapiton se io onomasusa.
Epiphany Day here at St. Sophia Greek Orthodox Church in Valley Forge yielded another surprise. We have Anthony and Carrie Limberakis, who witnessed and were part of a special ceremony to honor their father. Gentlemen, welcome to Cosmos Philly. Let's talk first about your father and then about the plaque. Okay. Who was your father so people really know?
So Father John A. Limberakis served this community for 10 years from 2000 to 2010. 1990 to 2000, excuse me. In 2010 he passed away. And it was prior to his passing that a friend of mine, Zenos Fridakis, who is a sculptor of renowned reputation, asked if we thought it was a good idea to have a bas relief made of my dad. And we said, absolutely. So I brought my dad to his studio in Glenside, Pennsylvania, and Zenos did a magnificent job with the bas relief. Well, we knew at some point down the road after he had passed that we would like to incorporate that into a plaque. It's taken a number of years for that plaque to be composed, designed, and fabricated, and the day has come when it was installed. So prior to St. Sophia, my dad served
his very first parish. I'm Anthony Limberakis, younger brother of my beloved brother Kerry Kyriakos. He, for his first parish, now know that my father was born and raised in Boston, Massachusetts, East Coast. His very first parish was Fresno, California, where my brother and I were born.
St. George.
My mom was a California person, so they had gone to, they needed a church. The Archdiocese at that time needed a priest, a dynamic young priest. They sent my father. Within a few years, he led the parish to build a beautiful church, St. George in Fresno, California. And not long ago, I was speaking with Metropolitan Gerasimos on the phone, me in Philadelphia, he in California, and he was on his way to St. George, Fresno. And he said, I'm on my way to St. George, Fresno. I said, Your Eminence, my dad built that church with the parishioners, my nona nona are there.
Yeah, number one.
So that was Fresno. Then from Fresno, they decided to go back to the East Coast, where they went to Providence, Rhode Island, the largest parish in Rhode Island. It was located in a modest area, we'll leave it at that, modest. And they relocated under his leadership to a lush, beautiful suburb, Cranston, Rhode Island, built a brand new church. Archbishop Iakovos was at the Theodonixia. Magnificent church, neo-Byzantine
style
architecture.
In the round.
From there, my late father-in-law, Dr. Borden, who was the president of the parish of the Annunciation in Elkins Park, they were in the midst of trying to build a new church. They went to Archbishop Iakovos and said, we need a priest to help lead us. So Archbishop Iakovos, also of blessed memory, assigned my father to Saints to the Annunciation, Elkins Park. Sure enough, another church, another Theodonixia that happened 50 years ago, almost to the day, where Archbishop Iakovos led, opened the doors of the church. And then as my dad was thinking about retirement,
another community needed
another
his guidance.
Another community needed his guidance, right.
He was not going to retire. He was assigned to this parish. And when we first arrived at this parish on Center Avenue or Center Street in Norristown, yeah, it was a very, very small community of perhaps 35 families in a house that was transitioned into a Greek Orthodox church.
It was a house that was made into a church.
Right.
So if you look around and you see first the cultural center, and now Father Peter, what Father Peter has done in this parish, taking the baton from my father, a couple of people in between, but leading the parish to building this incredible Byzantine jewel with the iconography. So we really salute Father Peter. We're honoring my father, but he takes this honor, and we take this honor in tribute to the parish priests of St. Sophia, but especially Father Peter, who is such a dynamic, inspirational leader.
An amazing story. Your father was a pioneer, a builder,
yes,
of houses of worship.
Yes.
We had no idea. That must make you proud to know that he's led this effort around the country.
Yeah.
He came from Pomfret, the original seminary of our archdiocese, Pomfret, Connecticut. And he was part of that original class of pioneer priests.
And so what I was going to say is that Archbishop Iakovos of blessed memory nicknamed my dad the builder of churches.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
It's a great story again.
Indeed.
Yeah. We're very grateful for sharing this. I have one follow-up question for the two of you. When the ceremony was going on next door, what was going through your minds? What were you feeling both? Let me start over here with Anthony.
Well, being a PK, priest kid, you see the sacrifice the priest and his wife, Presbytera, our mother, make throughout their ministries, because it's a ministry. And we thought this is such a wonderful, fitting tribute to the sacrifices, to the love that they have given to the parish, and have the parish give back a sign of respect and love is really just a milestone in our family, in the parish, in the community.
Carrie?
Well, I was transported back in about, I guess, 12, 13, 14 years when the parish, on my dad's retirement, hosted a testimonial in which parishioners from each of the four parishes, the three previous ones from Rhode Island and California and Elkins Park, attended. And there were over 400 people. The Metropolitan was here to do the dedication. And I remember our families and our Theo and Thea from California, Massachusetts, cousins being present and to be together for such an auspicious milestone in my dad's ministry. That's where I was transported to, and it got me a little misty-eyed.
I'm sure, yeah.
But it's, as we said earlier, a very fitting tribute to my dad, and we're very, very proud of his work as a priest.
I'd like to make one more comment. This is the Epiphany, right? Theophania, one of the great feast days of the Church. This also happens to be the day my late father-in-law, Dr. Borden, who was the prior commander several generations back of the Order of St. Andrew, passed away this very day 28 years ago. So there's a lot of significance of the Epiphany. First and foremost, of course, the baptism of our Lord and Savior. But to this family, the Limberakis family, tremendous significance. And well, we were baptized.
Yeah, we're at
in the River Jordan.
We ourselves have been.
Wow.
Yes, yeah.
My dad led 10 pilgrimages to the Holy Land.
Another piece of history we had no idea.
Yeah, 10 pilgrimages.
He was quite an amazing person in our community. And today we honor him and we acknowledge. And may his memory be eternal. Thank you to your families and everything you guys have done to continue to support this community. Thank you so much, and have a happy new year. Thank you.
Thank you. We're very honored.
Thank you very much.
About sponsoring or viewing the interview series, visit the Greek American Heritage Society of Philadelphia online at ghsp.org.